you know, climate change has become like a much more well-recognized issue. And I think financial markets are also now starting to recognize it's a major issue. And we just don't have many tools that allow us to manage this risk. So for example, you know, for many other risks, like many macro risks, for example, we have derivative markets that allow us to really manage the risk and transfer the risk around the economy. But for climate change, we don't. And so I think that there's a lot of work to be done in order to understand how financial markets can help in providing solutions to climate change and the problems that come with it.
To the extent that there's this pervasive desire to hedge climate risk throughout the economy, then this has interesting equilibrium ramifications. Prices should start to reflect people's desire to hold assets that pay off when climate risk is high. And this is exactly the resource reallocation function of markets. If everybody's now interested in doing this, finding these assets that appreciate when climate risk is high and climate outcomes are bad, well then the prices of those assets are going to rise. And if everybody's interested in selling assets that tend to do poorly in these bad climate outcomes, they're especially climate exposed, well then people are going to be selling those assets up front now. So these types of assets, think of it as maybe a coal producing firm, these are going to start to lose value now. They're going to be unattractive investments today, which is just the economy's way of reallocating resources to these projects that are actually in the long run mitigating climate risk. So this, by hopefully making some of this hedging benefit more accessible, we would hope that prices sort of equilibrate more efficiently to reflect the collective demand for less climate risk investments.
We don't understand the effects of climate change on the economy. We don't understand how our actions affect climate change. We don't understand whether we're going to be able to adapt or mitigate climate change. So there's so much uncertainty about the underlying process. And so it's almost impossible for anyone to figure out what to do, which in turn is one of the main issues with thinking about cross-sectoral market for climate change.
Yeah, this is a different problem than most types of risks that financial markets are sort of well-suited to hedge, in the sense that it's a risk that is very tough to detect and it's very long-dated. The bad consequences we expect to be sort of much further out in the future than the typical risks that we're used to hedging in the financial market. Right? You think about the financial market, it's well-suited for investors that are trying to essentially trade on and hedge against things that are sort of like business cycle risk. So think about fluctuations that happen every 2 to 3 years or more frequently. And now we're talking about a risk where some of the worst outcomes might be 50 years or more off. So not only are they very hard to measure, it's hard to think about how you feel about things that are going to happen in such distant future. You start to have to worry about issues that you wouldn't consider about with a lot of normal stock market risk, like how do I feel about my descendants' well-being. Right? This is something that comes into play when you're thinking about climate risk.